Friends, on behalf of W.J. Jones & Son Funeral Services, I welcome you to our 24th annual Morning Star Service. I welcome you into the sanctuary of this sacred virtual gathering. And I pray that in this sacred time and space that we share, that you feel connected to us through the music, the candlelight, the inspirations. There is no substitute for face-to-face experience. Yet in everyone's best interest and in an effort to be all-inclusive, we connect with you virtually. I hope that you feel our healing thoughts and love infused into every part of this ceremony. The sights and the sounds of the holiday season are upon us, and as a team who is sensitive to grief's realities, we offer you this gentle pause where we can step away from the busyness and the business of the season and honor your heart and its needs. It is our great hope that you will find insights and inspirations to carry you through this season and all that this season means to you. 24 years ago, this event was entitled Morning Star, named after the star that shines right before sunrise, symbolizing the hope of a new day. And every year since then, it has been our prayer that this ceremony raises the light of hope for all who mourn at Christmas. Each year, we build the Morning Star ceremony around a certain theme and symbol. And this year, we chose the theme of priceless connections. In a year where we have experienced the isolation of disconnection, we felt it important to highlight the value of keeping connected with yourself, with those in your life, and with your beloved who's no longer with us. And we chose the dime as a symbol for our memorial ornament this year because it was the most referenced sign people have spoken about this year. And so our memorial ornament is a shiny new 2020 dime with this verse, "Heaven sent." A dime found is sent with love, an angel blessing from above, a sign that says we are not apart, a priceless connection of the heart. These ornaments are available on a first-come, first-served basis here at the funeral home, 474 Hochelaga Street West, with one per household. And we hope it's a meaningful symbol of the season for you, reminding you of the value of priceless connections. And now in the quiet of this shared space and virtual connection, we share Morning Star 2021. Of all of the milestone events throughout the year, Christmas tends to be a time when our grief is amplified exponentially. Traditions and all of the sensations that come with those traditions tend to accentuate the missing of our beloveds. And thoughts of them naturally fill our mind and our heart. To open our ceremony, we're honored to have Joya Johnston singing a song that voices the curiosity of many of us as we think about our beloveds, wondering, what is heaven like for them? Let's listen.
What Christmas in heaven is like. There's a little manger scene down on 3rd and Main. I must have walked right by it 1,000 times, but I see it now in a different light, 'cause I know you are there. And I wonder, are you kneeling with shepherds before him now? Can you reach out and touch his face? Are you part of that glorious holy night? I wonder what Christmas in heaven is like. Is the snow falling down on the street? I wonder what Christmas in heaven is like.
Thank you so much, Joya. As Christmas draws near, so does the longest night of the year. It's a time when darkness fills the hours, and that can weigh heavily for the bereaved. And so we encourage the adding of light. Today we have tea lights lit to symbolically honor your beloveds, lights that twinkle with hope and inspiration. And our team is now going to add to this display of light with the lighting of the ceremonial candles.
My name is Dana Chamberlain, and I'm the general manager of W.J. Jones & Son Funeral Services. And on behalf of our team, I want to offer you our heartfelt wishes for this Christmas season, that it be filled with meaningful memories, peaceful pauses, and much love. We are sorry for your loss, and so sorry that we're unable to meet face-to-face with you in our chapel once again. And yet, we are so grateful to have the technology to meet you where you are at, with the help of Benjamin Keller, our videographer. We hope this ceremony offers you healing and hope for your heart as you navigate this holiday season. While we traditionally have you light a tea light when you enter our chapel, today we've placed tea lights as a gesture of universal honor. May their light shine like hope for you. And now, with the help of our funeral directors, Christine Dacey, Kelly Scott, Blake Seaback, and Lou Young, we light the ceremonial candles. Today we light these ceremonial candles for your grief, for your courage, for your memories, and for your love. The first candle represents your grief. The pain of your loss is intense. The rich glow of this candle reminds us of the depth of your love, and that grief is the price that we pay for having loved so deeply. The second candle represents your courage. The courage to confront your sorrow, the courage to comfort each other, and the courage to adjust to this reality. This third candle represents your memories. The times you laughed, the times you cried, the milestones you attained, the moments you shared that are forever etched in your hearts. This fourth candle represents your love. The bond you had and will forever have with your beloved, a connection that cannot be broken, and the love you have for yourselves, loving yourselves into a new way of being, a life calls you forward, and the love of the author of all love. May angels shine their light upon your grief, your courage, your memories, and your love, and bring healing to your hurting hearts. Love and light to you.
On September 6th, heaven gained a very bright light when my precious friend and a second mom, Irene Gragans, passed from this world to the next. Irene was an extraordinary woman. Just ask anyone who had the privilege of knowing her. She lived with an attitude of gratitude, and it was through her gratitude that she experienced life's joy. Knowing her in life was an absolute privilege, and walking with her family in preparation for her celebration of life was an immense honor. While meeting with her family, her daughter Glenda said, "Gerry wrote a song for Mom, and you've got to hear it." To say I was moved is an understatement. I've asked him to share it with us today, because through his poignant lyrics, he has captured Irene's essence and inspiration. I'm going to let him give the background story to this song, but suffice it to say, it is all about priceless connections.
So as Della said, my mother-in-law was Irene Gragans, and as she has noted, she was an individual that you only come across once in a lifetime. And at the beginning of the pandemic, back in spring of 2020, when everybody started really locking down, we thought it was going to be an intensely difficult time for her. She was still living happily and independently in Athabasca Towers in her own apartment. And she was an incredibly social and sociable person. And to then suddenly go into lockdown and not be able to share all the things that were really important to her, the card games with her friends, visits, funerals. She loved going to funerals. We thought it was going to be an extremely difficult time for her. But instead, we found that she remained very, very happy. And in talking to her, Glenda found that Irene was having dreams. And In her dreams, she was with all the people that she had lost along the way. She was with her sister. She was with her husband. And she was taking huge comfort from these dreams and from these visions. And she would wake up in the morning and feel really quite wonderful, and she would keep that presence with her all day until she went back to bed at night and they joined her again. And I thought that was just an incredibly sweet thing. So I wrote this song for her. And so she heard it during her life, and she did like it, fortunately. Her comment was, "Gee, I didn't know Gerry actually liked me that much." But at the end of it, when she did pass, I was asked if I would sing it. And all of a sudden, we realized that in that context, it was every bit as appropriate or apt as it was while she was still alive. So I wrote the song as an old country waltz in her honor, and I like to think of it as the kind of a song that she and my father-in-law might have been dancing to at the Mortlach Town Hall in 1956. It's called Quarantine Dream.
¶¶ Well, I've been around for a long time, known love and loss and fear. But I've never seen anything like this my 97 years. Well, they say that it came from China, swept across the seas and land. Now I'm stuck in my apartment, too much time on my hand. And those still with me can't visit, but the dear ones who've gone before me share my night soon as I close my eyes for my beautiful quarantine dream. My beautiful quarantine dream. And some of you worry about dying, and some of you worry about me. But every night I steal away those I've lost along the way. Wake up in the morning, feel them with me all day. From my beautiful quarantine dream. Well, they shut down our canasta, barred the door to our social room. The Blue Jays ain't playing, the curling's on ice. So what is a poor soul to do? Well, me, I've taken to sleeping, and my dreams, well, they ain't so bad. Spent time with my dear sister and in the arms of your darling dad. And when I wake late in the morning, they stay right with me, it seems, till I go back to bed and meet them in my head and my beautiful quarantine dream. My beautiful quarantine dream. Most of you worry about dying, and some of you worry about me. But every night I steal away those I've lost along the way. Wake up in the morning, feel them with me all day. They're my beautiful quarantine dream. Some call me a force of nature, never pushed down to my knees. But this is one situation best taken lying down, it would seem. Who knows how long this will go on? Who knows how much time I've got left? If I'm still here when we get the all clear, I'll go back to my old life, I guess. But I'll never forget my precious nights with the arms of those passed around me. When it's my time, I'll meet them on that side, just like in my quarantine dream. My beautiful quarantine dream. Now most of you worry about dying, and some of you worry about me. But every night I steal away those I've lost along the way. Wake up in the morning, feel them with me all day. And my beautiful quarantine dream. My beautiful quarantine dream.
I want to thank Gerry for that powerful song and for bringing Irene back to us for that time. Each December, as the year comes to a close, I open my spirit to receive a word of intention for the new year, a word that really resonates in my soul. Well, in December of 2019, 4 months before the whole world was shut down by the pandemic, my soul chose the word pivot. Little did I know the value that that word pivot would have in my life that year. As 2020 drew to a close, I gave thanks for the insights that intention had served, and I opened myself to my new word. And has been the experience for about a dozen years. The intention arose in my soul, and I smiled. My intention for 2021 became holy connections. And with that new intention, I entered another COVID year where more than any time in my life, I experienced the value of collaboration and connections. And I experienced the holy through them. Holy connections. Elizabeth Kubler-Ross once said, "The pain of loss is so intense, so heartbreaking, because in loving we deeply connect to another human being, and grief is a reflection of the connection we feel has been lost. Our grief is a reflection of a very holy connection. Our healing work can move us forward to a holy connection with our beloved, with ourself, and with our world in a whole new way. As we enter this holiday season, I find many bereaved feel disconnected with the merriment of Christmas. Some would like to skip Christmas and get right into January 2nd. The thought of the season just feels so overwhelming. I'd like to encourage you to actually connect with that feeling of disconnect and connecting with that which truly serves your heart and your soul this season. One bereaved mom wrote about her feelings of disconnect after the loss of her daughter, and she shared these powerful insights, writing, "The beauty of accepting the disconnect was it gave me time to understand my grief, to get to know the person that I was becoming, and to get acclimated to the new normal in my life, to a life without my eldest daughter, Rachel, physically in it, and to the possibilities that only Rachel's death could bring into my life. So when I was ready to reconnect with the world, it was on my terms, with a new perspective on life, a renewed sense of purpose, and resolve to help others who are grieving as well. In the same way that this moment you have disconnected from the world's chaos and connected with the grief and with your grief and with the quiet of this ceremony, I encourage you to seek more connections like these, to intentionally make connections that serve you well. Here's a few connections that I have seen the bereaved that have served them well. Connect with yourself and your inner voice on a soul level. Listen to your heart. Hear your gut's response. Be aware. Connect with yourself as if you were a special friend. Connect with the present moment through mindful practices, reading a short passage and just sitting with its words, letting them ripple through your psyche, sitting with your grief and allowing it to speak its truth, pausing to simply breathe, just being. Connect with those who honor you without judgment or expectation that you need to be fixed. People who bring out the best in you, people with whom you can have guiltless discussions and that offer genuine understanding, people who are okay with simply being together. Connect with nature and with the wisdom of creation. Open yourself to nature's inspirations by simply quietly observing. Feel the grounding power of the earth below your feet. Infuse yourself with the beauty of the sky above and enliven yourself with the power of the trees standing firm in your presence. Connect with the divine and the holy that's in each moment. With eyes wide open to your heart, it's amazing what we can see with spiritual eyes. And connect in new ways with your beloved, because while death ends a life, it doesn't hold a power over our love. Connect to your love and open yourself to the essence of your loved one being with you in new ways. That bereaved mom I spoke of earlier concluded, "Amazingly, almost 8 years after my daughter Rachel's death, I feel more connected to her now than I ever did. She has become an integral part of my very being and is never very far from my thoughts and daily routine. Her memory lives on in so many ways in my life, and her love of life is reflected so beautifully in the faces and actions of my grandchildren. And just when I feel lonely or saddened by a sudden memory or other trigger, I'm gently reminded that she is near. For instance, just yesterday morning, as I reached for the handle of my car door, I spied a dime lying on the ground. As I bent down to pick it up, I silently whispered, 'Good morning, Rachel.' As I started the engine, I couldn't help but smile as a feeling of comfort and warmth flooded over me. This holy holiday season, it's our hope that you experience the power of priceless connections and consider setting that as a personal intention. And in so doing, I hope that you too find the holy while doing so." Let's think upon that while listening to Joya Johnson sing "Angels Among Us."
Shortcut through the woods, and I lost my way. It was getting late, and I was scared and alone. Then a kind old man took my hand, and he led me home. Mama couldn't see him, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayer. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. When life had troubled times and had me down on my knees, there's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger, to lend a helping hand. A phone call from a friend, just to say I understand. Now ain't it kind of funny, at the dark end of the road, someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope.
I believe there are angels among us, and one of them sitting at the piano and singing absolutely beautiful, Joya. Thank you so much. As I was preparing for this ceremony, our son texted and he asked if I'd listen to the new song out by Ed Sheeran. And when he sends me a song, I drop everything and I listen, knowing he felt it was important and meaningful. And was it ever? I want to share the lyrics because they very much resonate with our theme of connections. Ed wrote this song for the memorial ceremony for a father figure and mentor. They are such an expression of his heart. Visiting Hours by Ed Sheeran. I wish that heaven had visiting hours so I could just show up and bring the news that she's getting older, and I wish that you'd met her. The things that she'd learned from me, I got them all from you. I wish that heaven had visiting hours so I could just swing by and ask your advice. What would you do in my situation? I haven't a clue how I'd even raise them. What would you do? Because you always do what's right. Can we just talk a while until my worries disappear? I'd tell you that I'm scared of turning out a failure. You'd say, remember that the answer's in the love that we create. So much has changed since you've been away. I wish that heaven had visiting hours, and I would ask them if I could take you home. But I know what they'd say, that it's for the best. So I'll live life the way you taught me and make it on my own. I'll close the door, but I will open up my heart. And everyone I love will know exactly who you are. Because this is not goodbye. It's just till we meet again. So much has changed since you've been away. Well, I too wish heaven had visiting hours. And on some level, I think it does. As we experience the priceless connections of the heart. Friends, I ask that you please be gentle and patient and kind to yourself as you journey through this season. And please remember the true gift of this season is the greatest connector of all. It's love. We close this ceremony with a final song by Joya, a song that has stood the test of the decades, offering its hopeful message that no matter where you go, no matter how overwhelmed you feel, you never, ever walk alone. May you walk feeling the priceless connections of those you love and those who love you, trusting that the author of love is with you every step of the way. Amen.